Aquí estamos en la última venta de garage antes de partir. Nos queda una semana para irnos.
Irnos.
How is it going, babe? Are we selling everything today?
Okay.
We haven't had many people today.
Después de tres ventas de garage, de vender un auto, de empacar, regalar y vender todas nuestras cosas, de trabajar bastante en Sandy, la forerunner que nos acompaña a cruzar el país, Nate hizo una ducha que funciona a presión y podemos llevar aproximadamente 15 litros de agua con nosotros. También instaló el roof rack para poder llevar más equipaje arriba, ya que dormimos en el auto, así que necesitamos el espacio adentro. Después de despedirnos de los amigos y la familia, de un cambio de batería y aceite para el auto, después de limpiar la casa y entregarla, y después de muchos otros detalles que ahora no me acuerdo, por fin lo logramos. Y estamos listos para partir.
Here we go.
Y nuestro primer destino es Yosemite.
¿Estás listo para ir a un hike?
Somos listos. Todo el tiempo. Todo el mundo. Ellos no saben. Ellos no saben nada.
Is the water frozen in the shower?
Yes, it is. I can't even open this.
No? Bueno, se nos congeló el agua de la ducha, obviamente.
Yeah, it's frozen.
Yeah. Por ahora no hay ducha. Buenos días. Entonces queríamos acá hacer este video para darles algunos tips del Yosemite. Información importante si quieren venir. En esta fecha estamos a... What day is today? October 31st.
Today is October 31st. It's Halloween.
Halloween. Entonces sería otoño. Y los tips son que se compren el pase anual si quieren viajar por muchos parques nacionales. El valor es de $80 y dura un año. How much is the vehículos.
So, getting here, we thought that the $35 pass was good for maybe 3 days, but it turns out the $35 pass to Yosemite is good for, I believe, 7 days. So if you're coming and you plan on spending less than 7 days, $35 gets you in, gets it done. If you plan on spending more than 7 days, then you're gonna have to, you know, buy another pass for $35 more. We really like the annual pass because we're gonna be going to a lot of different places and we can go in and out and it's not a problem.
Yeah, the annual pass is really nice. Yeah. For us, at least, that we are traveling like long term.
Yeah. And here in the fall, we're here, you know, almost November tomorrow. So it's cold, really, really cold here in the mornings and at night, but it's been absolutely beautiful during the daytime. Ran into far less people than you would in the summertime.
Yeah.
We didn't make reservations to come in because it was after October 11th, which was their cutoff for, requiring reservations this year. The weather has been just beautiful during the day, so it's not too hot. You're hiking and it's been sunny outside for us, but not too hot. It's been really, really nice.
It's really nice for hiking, yeah. In the night, it gets really cold, but luckily we stay warm in Sandy, the 4Runner. We stay really warm there, so yeah, we are lucky.
Yeah. It's been just a great experience. We came in from the south entrance.
We came in through...
Correct. We came in through the north entrance.
North, yeah.
And stayed at a campsite there for just one night because we were got in there around 6 o'clock.
Late.
And there was a campsite right close to the north entrance. And so we made camp there. It was nice, but... not a lot of people again, which was great. We didn't have any problems just finding a spot. It was $28 a night. $28 a night. And then the next day we went into Yosemite Valley, looked around, asked about, places to stay in the valley. And they didn't have anything available for us in the valley. So
in the valley, es como la área central, donde están todas las atracciones principales del parque. El Capitán, el Half Dome y todas esas como atractivos turísticos están en el valley, que es la área central.
Most of the things you want to see are in the valley. So if you do stay at one of these campsites, outer campsites like we've been doing, it's about a 45-minute drive into the valley to get to the major hikes and the major outlooks and the real, real beauty. However, I really do think that this is a great campsite. We ended up moving from the north side of Hedgepog, I believe it's called Hedgepog Campground, and we're now at the Wawona Campground, which is at the other end in the south.
South, yeah. It's really beautiful here.
And yeah, this campsite has just been amazing. We're right next to the little river here.
Yeah.
We just got a beautiful site where we were able to reserve for four nights upon arrival. So
for how much? For
$28 a night.
Again.
Yep. So
there is no shower in this campground, though. There is no shower.
Yep. No shower, no hot water.
Yeah. We don't want a shower anyway. It's too cold.
Yeah. Yep. But
we have the river here.
Yep.
And we can get water from there to drink water, to wash our dishes, and for anything.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
It's really been great. The water here is super nice, and I just have a little water filter that can purify the water so that it's safe to drink right out of the river, which is great.
Yeah, that's super a super good thing to have. Yeah.
Yep.
And it's very small too. What else am I important?
I was trying to think of something.
So how far are we from the main attractions? Like,
we're about 45 minutes.
45 minutes. So yep. If we want to go to El Capitan or anywhere there, the museum, we have to drive 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Super curvy road.
Yeah. But
yeah, it's beautiful.
Even if you spent some time here hanging out, I think you would still really enjoy it. You really can't go wrong.
No.
I mean, they said Wawona Campground, which is where we're at, fills up pretty quickly, but In our experience, like late in the season like this, there still hasn't been a lot of people here.
On weekends maybe, but not. I don't think it's full.
Yeah.
On weekends either. Yeah.
It's been pretty nice.
Yeah. So
we were really happy to be able to get a campsite without a reservation and be able to show up and reserve multiple days.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to vacate the campsite every night and then come back and try to get your same campsite. You can reserve for multiple days once you show up. Also, you can pay with credit card, which makes things easier. You just write your credit card number on the little slip and pay by credit card. So don't worry about making sure you have cash or anything. Mm-hmm. One thing I did notice was that I believe park entry is credit card only. So if you're coming here, you don't have a pass, and you plan on, you know, just buying the $35 7-day pass to Yosemite, from what I saw, it was credit cards only. So that's one thing to keep in mind.
Yeah. It's kind of weird. Why?
Yeah, a little strange.
Yeah. But I think it's Yosemite. We will see in the rest of the national parks. But
yeah.
Okay, so that's pretty much
everything. We're going to be leaving here today.
Yep.
They're closing this particular loop of the campground today, which means we'd have to move to the... just really close, less than a quarter mile away. But we're looking at snow on Wednesday and high temperatures of 27, 28 degrees and lows in the single digits.
How much is that in Celsius? For my people? Celsius people?
It would be in the negative numbers.
Bajo cero. Van a estar bajo cero el miércoles.
Yeah.
A ver, nieve también, así que... we'd rather to leave before that.
Yeah. So, we feel like we've seen a lot of good stuff here, I think. And and it's been a good time. We could spend a couple more days here, but I think we're both pretty happy with what we've seen. We went on a really nice hike of Vernal Falls and Nevada Falls, which kind of gives you good, really good views of just the valley and Half Dome, some waterfalls. It's just been really beautiful.
Yeah,
but
amazing.
Yeah, today we're going to be leaving through the Tioga Pass. So we came in through the north entrance. We're now staying super close to the south entrance. And we will be leaving today through the east entrance. So the east entrance is going to be kind of fun. It's called the Tioga Pass. They close it in November. So that's one thing to keep in mind, which is another reason why we're taking off now, is to try to get to our next destination before the Tioga Pass closes. But we plan on seeing some beautiful views up there. You see a lot of a lot of places up there that people
nobody,
just don't go.
Yeah.
You know, some beautiful lakes, I believe, are up there. Some other really cool rock formations, that kind of stuff. So in a few minutes here, we're going to pack everything up and get on the road.
Yeah, we're going to be crossing the national park. Vamos a cruzarlo de oeste a este. Y vamos a pasar por Tenaya Lake. Tenaya Lake is the name, right?
Mm-hmm.
Tayana.
Tenaya. Tenaya.
Tenaya Lake.
Mm-hmm.
Un lago que se ve bastante grande en el mapa. Así que ahí vamos a hacer más videitos y les vamos a mostrar qué tal la cruzada del parque. Bueno, eso sería todo. That's it.
That's it. We'll see you when we get where we're going.
Adiós.